μέρους της Δημοτικής Επιτροπής Τουρισμού του νησιού μας, θέλουμε να σας ευχαριστήσουμε που είστε απόψε εδώ σε μια συνάντηση η οποία πιστεύω είναι ξεχωριστή. Είναι ξεχωριστή διότι φιλοδοξούμε ανάμεσά μας δύο αναρχητές με παγκόσμιες διακρίσεις, τον Νικολά Φαβρέζε και τον Πάτσι Ζομπιάνγκα. Εμείς τους καλωσορίζουμε και τους ευχαριστούμε που είναι σήμερα μαζί μας. Επιτρέψτε μου μόνο για δύο λεπτά.
This is a special night, and he would like to present you first our two guests.
Ο Νικολά Φαβρές είναι κάτοχος του βραβείου Χιολέτο, η μεγαλύτερη διάκριση στον χώρο του αλπινισμού. Αναδικάται σε ανεξερεύνητα βουνά και ελευθερώνει νέες διαδρομές σε όλο τον κόσμο. Διακρίνεται σε όλα τα είδη αναρρίγησης, με δύσκολες διαδρομές, στην αθλητική πάντα αναρρίγηση, στο μπούντερινγκ και στην παραδοσιακή αναρρίγηση.
Nicolas Chalmers is the owner of the Pelletor, which is the most prestigious prize you can win in alpinism. The last years he's been focused on freeing the girls in all over the world. He was also an all-around climber with big distinctions in bouldering, sport climbing, and also alpinism track climbing.
Ο Πάτσι Ζομπιάνγκα, ο οποίος βρίσκεται στην κορυφή της διεθνούς ανταγωνιστικής αναλύγης τα τελευταία 7 χρόνια. Και το Παγκόσμιο Πρωτάθλημα το 2009. Είναι ο πρώτος αναδεκητής που σκαρφάλωσε on-site, δηλαδή με την πρώτη διαδρομή της σχολείας, 8 C+, στη γλώσσα των αναδεκητών, και έχει σκαρφαλώσει διαδρομές με βαθμό δυσκολίας μέχρι και 9 A+.
Pachi Zobiaga is at the top of the international competition circuit for the last 7 years. Yeah. He's also the first one to have on-site an A+ and has climbed up to 9+.
Εμείς θέλουμε να τους ευχαριστήσουμε, να τους ευχηθούμε να έχουν πάντοτε επιτυχίες στη ζωή τους και να μην ξεχνούν ποτέ την κάλυμα που τους αγαπάει ιδιαίτερα.
We'd like to thank them for being here and wish them always being successful in whatever they do, with great distinctions, and to always remember Kalinos.
Και τώρα ο Νικολά Φαβρέζε θα μας παρουσιάσει σε όλους εμάς την ταινία του που ακούει στο όνομα Vertical Sailing Crimson και είναι μία η τελευταία του αποστολή στην Γρυλανδία. Ας την απολαύσουμε όλοι μαζί.
And now Nico will present his movie Vertical Sailing Greenland from the Yaz Expedition in Greenland.
Ευχαριστώ.
Okay, maybe you can turn off a bit the light here, it's okay? Just so we can see better the pictures. So I'm going to show some image of my last expedition last summer in Greenland. We went by ferry boat to climb some virgin walls that starts just from the ocean, that just go straight from the water, straight up. And we went 3 months. Just to explore, just things that are totally nobody knows about. And I had the idea of, yeah, I had the idea to do this trip, to combine the sailing with climbing to approach all these walls that are so inaccessible. And while researching for information, I quickly get in touch with this guy. This guy, his name is Bob Shilton. He has been to Greenland about 7 times with his sailboat. And when I asked him if he had seen any nice walls to climb, he directly replied to me, would you be by any chance interested to go this, this year I have my boat there, and I had to leave it in Greenland because last year I was on an expedition, I couldn't bring it back, I was too late in the season to bring it back. And but you can imagine, this guy is 75 years old, he's a Scottish priest, and I just met him by email, and this was like 2 months before the trip had to happen. So we're quite anxious about who would spend this time with. His boat was very slow, and we decided to go 5 in his boat. So his boat is 10 meters. Okay, in the Mediterranean, 10 meters is okay, but then in the north, in the Atlantic, with all the climbing gear, port ledge, and it's pretty tight. And yeah, that was a nice, interesting experience, just to get to know him. Here we meet him for the first time in Greenland, so we just talked, exchanged a few emails, and we arrived in Greenland where he had his boat. And to test his personality direct, we decided to offer him this very nice drink. It's a hard alcohol with a cobra and the scorpion. And he, for a special occasion, he would drink it. He said he liked it, but he I don't know why, he called it the devil's brew. And with his boats in Greenland, we did many nice first ascents. In the old type of climbing, perfect cracks, and also always in a very wild place where nobody had been before. So this is inside boat, and so 5 of us in this 10-meter boat. As you can imagine, the organization order was very important, and as you can see, with this we were very good. And Bob was even, to our positive surprise, was even better at it than us. And the only place where we could get a bit of privacy on the boat is the top of the mast. And there, Davy would take a little break from the action inside the boat and just stay there a little bit, see the view, and that would feel good once in a while. So the expedition was me, my brother Olivier, Sean Villanueva is a climber, a Belgian climber who has climbed a lot of... what?
The lights.
Ah, the lights. We cannot turn off these lights, please. So Sean Villanueva is a... I started climbing with him, and we've done most of the adventurous climbs I've done with him. And then Bendito, an American friend, so we're 4, plus Bob. And from the 4 of us, 2, Ben and Sean, had never sailed before, so it was quite interesting for them. And as well for me and Olivier, we had sailed before, but always in the Mediterranean. And here it's very different, the waves are much bigger, there is icebergs. And so Bob had to teach us a lot of things with his sailboat. And he, you might think he's teaching us how to sail, but in fact he was just telling us, climb this wall and this wall. He was very strict about the orders. But we quickly noticed that with his sailboat we could do basically whatever we wanted, as long as he could read, relax in his bedroom, and sleep. So basically, he was spending maybe 20 hours of the day there, just reading books and sleeping like this with maybe 5 pillows. Pretty incredible person. And yeah, once Ben and Sean was taking over the sailing, sometimes it would get a little funky. As you can imagine, it was not always easy to be on the boat. We did a lot of crossing for 5-10 days without touching ground. But you know, really, the hardest thing for Sean was not the same, but was to leave his Facebook. He was always trying to get connected, but obviously there was no connection. So many days sailing, we cannot train, so we had to place a little finger board and keep the shape. So this is the kind of sea we have to sail in to approach the walls. There are big glaciers that spit out icebergs, and as you can see, it's different from sailing around Kalymnos. And if you kiss one of these icebergs with a fiberglass boat like this, you could lose it easily. And this is a picture that was taken when we were climbing a wall. He is about coming to check on us. And as you can see, the icebergs are really big, but here it's not even a big one. Some of them are more than 100 meters tall. And the dangerous part is not the big iceberg, but it's all these little pieces that are much smaller, and on the surface it only comes out a little bit, but below the surface it's very big. And here actually Bob was thinking to park his boat there, but we told him with the radio it was not a good idea. And just a moment later, a bit of the iceberg broke and lost its balance. This is what happened. Very nice spectacle. It happens a lot, huh? So Bob was sometimes very anxious with sailing in this water with the icebergs, as you can see. But we told him not never to be too anxious, because we were always paying very good attention on the ocean while sailing. And one of the main advantages we quickly noticed to go with a priest climbing is that when we go climbing, we really go for it, because Bob was praying for us and we knew there was no danger. God was with us. And here in the ocean was the same. You could open the icebergs like mummies and then we could pass through it. We had many visitors when we were sailing, lots of birds, seals. Here some dolphins that you have here also in the Mediterranean Sea. And then lots of whales. We saw maybe 20 times different whales at different occasions. It's always very nice to see and impressive. They are usually bigger than the sailboats. And here's a picture of a very rare whale. Not a lot of people have seen before. Okay, so now we'll play a little bit of music with some iceberg pictures. Underwater, so that's what we did here. We'll do it regularly. And the iceberg keep the water at very good temperature, usually about 4 or 5 degrees. This is the old Greenland is basically a big glacier, and on the coast you see this big glacier called the ice cap, like spit out some some of the glaciers come back down and spit out some icebergs. It's very unique views. And this is an area that Bob found. It was the first time to find this area. And this one is about 850 meters tall, almost vertical. This is about 500 meters tall. And when I got in touch with him by email, he sent me this picture, but he told him, "Sorry, but I cannot tell you where it is. I want to keep it for my expedition and my team. So if you want to climb this, you have to come with me." So then we have no choice. And yeah, you see, I will show a movie later, and you will see the ascent of this world. Very adventurous. Here we are getting prepared on Bob's boat. It's a strange feeling to get prepared for climbing on a sailboat. And here are the first pitch we start really from the boat. And it's a special atmosphere when you know that the water is so cold and you start with some hard moves, and if you fall you are in the water with the other climbing gear. Bob was always very enthusiastic with the climbing because he had seen this world for so long, and he had always dreamt about people to climb it. So he was very excited. But the first time he dropped us on the wall, we were a little worried because we were thinking, wow, what if he never comes back? What do we do? And we always wondered why we call Greenland, because it's mostly white, it's mostly like a big glacier. But then here we noticed why, it's because the cracks are all green. And that made up for some really nice adventures. You can see after a pitch the look of the backpack. Here it's a very interesting wet chimney we have to climb. Very nice adventure. And for this type of climbing, the mental concentration is very important. So this is the first wall we were looking at to climb. This is about 500 meters tall. And we were really psyched to climb this line. We're like, wow, a white line of granite. This is incredible. I've never seen it before. So we were very excited. And until we get a little closer, and we realized that it was all bird shit. And you have to imagine it's about 400 meters of bird shit there. So we chose a line more over here, trying to avoid those white patches. And the birds are very cute, they are just sleeping on the ledges. And most of them, you can see where they are. And it's nice to leave them alone and let them have their nest and things. And yeah, we thought they were really beautiful and very nice, until we noticed that they were protecting themselves by vomiting rotten fish. And as I told you before, the Greenland has a lot of green cracks. And I found out there is two really ways to climb these green cracks. Either you clean everything, it's very slow and very safe, or the method we usually use more was to clean the minimum and go for a long section without protection until you get a good hold where you can easily clean the crack and put another protection. And one time I did this, but I went for like 10 meters without protection. It was very delicate. It was the only way to outside the pitch, really. And I finally got to a good hold, and I was like so relieved. Oh, finally I will get a good protection. And at that exact moment, I lift my head up to just see what was next, and it was just a bird that was just synchronized perfectly the vomit in my face. And By the way, I had my mouth open, I just... I think he just wanted to be nice and share with food, his food with me, but... And the problem was like, it didn't go away. And also the thing I noticed, I thought he would puke one time and then he could not puke more, but he could puke many times. Then, so I did, since I did so many meters of delicate climbing, I couldn't go back down. My only way really was to fight with the bird, and I yelled as hard as I could to try to get the bird up, but it would not go away. So I took the biggest camelot I had, so the protection we used in the cracks, and I had to hit him. I mean, it was survival. I hope the bird protectors here understand, but it was really survival. If I fell, maybe I would have hurt myself or died. So I hit him, and even hitting him, I had to hit him four times before he went away. So that was a very interesting experience, and all of us got birds puke on us. And the smell in my mouth took 24 hours to go away, and the clothes, the whole expedition, even trying to wash it, it couldn't go away. So very powerful, these birds. So now I will show you some climbing pictures with some music, because the music say a lot more than the words.
Anchors,
And actually, out of the 9 rules, we opened 9 big rules there. We only placed 1 boat. So all the rules we could leave, it's like almost the way we found that. Just a bit less grass and maybe a few birds less. And part of our gear is we always bring our instruments. We are also a music band. And the boat was very good to get to play with the rhythm of the sea. But also we played with the rhythm of the mosquitoes. And here we played with some local Inuits in Greenland. This is the real chants of Greenland, basically. And we also initiate some little kids there, some future talents. And after each climb, we always look for the good jacuzzi to clean ourselves. And usually the water is really good temperature with the glacier just above. We did a slight detour to the Bahamas. After some climbing, it was good to relax a little bit. But here, as you can see, then you can see, Bob came in his boat very close, and when the tide came down, we got stuck on the ground. And we got stuck for 6 hours, so we didn't really know what to do, so we just occupied ourselves on his boat. And on the boat after the climbing, when we rest on the boat, there's always lots of things we need to do, like drinking wine, reading books, or fishing. And the fishing works really, really good in Greenland. Maybe in half hour, usually we have to stop because we have too many fish, mostly cut fish like this one. So maybe we catch in half hour four like this. And sometimes we have periods where for 2 weeks we just eat fish like this every day. And that was very nice to find our own foods in the natural environment. And we found other stuff, also mushrooms. We didn't really know what they were, but we tasted them and they were good. And also there were some mirtillas, blueberries, but there were some dangerous animals there. So that's a big question. So this is our captain. Bob Shepton is 75 years old, and he was always very excited about climbing, always getting very involved in when we were trying to pick a line and trying to decide where to climb. He was always telling us, no, you have to climb on this one, it looks too easy, that one, you should go to this one harder. And actually Bob, he's now just sailing, but 40 years ago he was a good climber, and he opened many routes in the UK. Many adventurous routes,